गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर यंग माइंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू बायोलॉजी सेशन। हाउ आर यू ऑल? आर यू फाइन? गुड। कम बैक टू सिचुएशन। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड लिंक रिएक्शन, दैट मीन्स एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन, स्टेप्स इन एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन सच एज लिंक रिएक्शन, क्रेब्स साइकिल। द टू टॉपिक्स वॉज कंप्लीटेड। वाट इज द साइट ऑफ लिंक रिएक्शन? वाट आर द एंड प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ लिंक रिएक्शन? Okay, how many NADH2 molecules formed in link reaction? The topic was completed. Followed by Krebs cycle. The total Krebs cycle, steps in Krebs cycle, end products of Krebs cycle, and what is the site of Krebs cycle, what is the importance of Krebs cycle, the total topic was completed. After completion of Krebs cycle, next topic continuation, ETS, electron transport system, important topic. Electron transport system, shortly called ETS, electron transport system. As I told previously, what is the site of electron transport system? Inner membrane of mitochondria, because it is one of the double membrane bound cell organelle. Inner membrane of mitochondria make a large number of inward foldings into the matrix. But a large number of inward finger-like projections are called cristae. The site of electron transport system is exactly on cristae. Clear? Once you go through mechanism of electron transport system. All of you practice mechanism, follow me. Complex 1, complex 3, next complex 2, complex 2, then complex 4, complex 4, inner mitochondrial membrane, mitochondrial membrane, it is complex 5. Complex 5, complex 1, complex 2, complex 3, complex 4 and complex 5. Clear? You don't confuse here. Follow the sequence, NCERT book mechanism. First complex 1, then complex 2, complex 3, complex 4 and complex 5. Follow the same sequence. Na BH plus H plus ions undergo oxidation in electron transport system to form NAD plus. NAD plus. It releases electrons into electron transport chain. The first electron acceptor is FMN2 iron sulfur, and from there to ubiquinone. UQ stands for ubiquinone to cytochrome B iron sulfur protein, and from there to cytochrome C1. Next, from cytochrome C1 to mobile electron carrier cytochrome C. Clear? Cytochrome C is mobile electron carrier. Cytochrome C to copper A to cytochrome A. Next, cytochrome A3. Next, copper B, and from there to oxygen, half O2 plus H2O means hydrogens. Half O2 plus hydrogens combined to form water molecule. It represents electron pathway. Two electrons. Electron pathway. The final electron acceptor is oxygen. Remember, don't confuse. Then go through complex 2. At complex 2, what happened? Complex to what happened means succinate convert into fumarate circulate turn into fumarate. At the same time, FeaDH2 oxidizes to FeaD plus. Clear? Right. FeaDH2 release electrons, both electrons and protons into complex 2. FeaD electron acceptor, FeaD to FeS iron sulfur protein, and from there to ubiquinone UQ, UQ ubiquinone, and from there to ubiquinone UQH2. Ubiquinol to cytochrome B, UQH2. Okay. Electrons. This is about electron pathway. Now go through proton pathway. For each electron, two protons translocated from matrix to intermembrane space. So, four protons. From complex 1, four protons. Complex 3, complex 2, complex 4, and complex 5. Clear? And from complex 3 also four protons translocated. From complex 1, four protons. From complex 3, again four protons translocated. From matrix, it is matrix. Inner membrane of mitochondria, intermembrane space, I show clearly. Next, from complex 4, two protons translocated. Clear? Four protons plus two protons. All protons translocated into matrix of mitochondria. It is an enzyme F0 and F1. Clear? Then go through ATP synthase enzyme. At ATP synthase enzyme, ADP plus inorganic phosphate combined to form ATP. ATP. Clear? Positive charge, negative charge. Okay. Positive charge, the negative charge. It is electrochemical gradient. Electrochemical gradient. Electrochemical gradient. This matrix, clear? Inner membrane, inner membrane. Inner membrane of mitochondria. No space, that is the problem. Inner membrane of mitochondria. This is intermembrane space. Inter membrane space. Intermembrane space. Clear? ETS, electron transport system. Here some enzymes play a crucial role at complex 1. NADH dehydrogenase enzyme. NADH dehydrogenase enzyme play a crucial role at complex 1. At a complex 2, succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. Succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. This enzyme play a crucial role at complex 2. Okay. And next it is complex 4 now. At complex 4, cytochrome C oxidase enzyme, short form. Cytochrome C oxidase enzyme. Clear? A brief, a simple diagram of mitochondria. This is the structure of mitochondria. You know, inner membrane. Inner membrane of mitochondria make large number of involved foldings called cristae. The site of electron transport system is exactly on cristae, means on inner membrane. Inner membrane, clear? Outer membrane, inner membrane, between two membranes, middle small gap is there, no? That is called intermembrane space. Intermembrane space. And it is matrix. Matrix. Okay, I am showing clearly what is the site of electron transport system, exactly on inner membrane of mitochondria. So observe carefully, outer membrane of mitochondria, inner membrane of mitochondria, between two membranes, middle small gap is there now, that is called intermembrane space. Intermembrane space. It is intermembrane space. Clear? Inner membrane. Clear? All complexes, all five complexes exactly located on the surface of the inner membrane of mitochondria. I wrote here, inner membrane. Clear? Matrix, dotted area represent matrix. It is matrix. Matrix. Clear? Now go through diagrammatic representation. First go through what are the complexes present in ETS, electron transport system. There are five complexes: complex 1, complex 2, complex 3, complex 4, and complex 5. Five complexes are there. Follow the same sequence. It is NCERT book mechanism. You don't confuse. Draw same mechanism as it is. Okay. Start from complex 1. I told previously glycolysis, link reaction, and Krebs cycle release NADH2 molecules and FADH2 molecules. All NADH2 molecules and FADH2 molecules release their energy in the form of ATP in ETS, electron transport system. Remember once previous videos. An example, glycolysis yield to NADH2 molecules, and link reaction also yield to NADH2 molecules, and Krebs cycle yield 6 NADH2 molecules and 2 FADH2 molecules. So all NADH2 molecules enter into complex 1. See, NADH2 molecules at a complex 1, NADH2 oxidized means release electrons and protons. That is called oxidation, removal of electrons, that means protons, from NADH2 is known as oxidation. So all glycolysis, link reaction and Krebs cycle, NADH2 molecules enter into complex 1. At a complex 1, they undergo oxidation, hence NADH2 become NAD+. Release electrons into electron transport pathway, and protons release into proton transport pathway. Proton transport pathway. First we discuss about electron transport pathway. Clear? You remember, for each electron, two protons translocated from matrix to intermembrane space. From matrix to intermembrane space. Clear? Each NADH2 molecule release two electrons. So two electrons. For each electron, two protons translocated. There are two electrons, means four protons translocated from matrix to intermembrane space through complex 1. Through complex 1, arrow mark showing clearly. You start from here. In complex 1, there are two electron carriers, FMN and FES. FMN stands for flavin mononucleotide. Flavin mononucleotide. F M N stands for flavin mono nucleotide. FES means iron sulfur. It is a protein. You know very well. So first, FMN pick up electrons from NADH2. Those electrons transfer to iron sulfur. Iron sulfur protein. Iron sulfur to ubiquinone. UQ stands for ubiquinone. UQ means ubiquinone. UQH2 means ubiquinol. Ubiquinol. Remember full forms, that also important. So iron sulfur protein donate their electrons into ubiquinol. So ubiquinol to ubiquinone to ubiquinol. Ubiquinone is a type of mobile electron carrier. It move one place to another. Ubiquinone pick up both electrons and protons. So ubiquinone become ubiquinol. Next, ubiquinol release electrons into complex 3, third complex. Clear? In complex 3, there are 3 electron carriers, cytochrome B, iron sulfur protein, cytochrome C1. Remember sequence, don't confuse. Ubiquinol to cytochrome B, cytochrome B to iron sulfur. Okay, so electrons move towards down. Okay, iron sulfur to cytochrome C1, cytochrome C1 to cytochrome C. Cytochrome C1 different, cytochrome C different, you don't confuse. Cytochrome C is another type of mobile electron carrier. So it carry electrons from complex 3 to complex 4. From complex 3 to complex 4. hence it is known as mobile electron carrier, like ubiquinone. Clear? Next, you stop from here, go through second complex. In second complex, succinate convert into fumarate. Succinate convert into fumarate in presence of an enzyme, namely succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. Succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. It is a catalyst. At the same time, FeTH2 molecules. That means I told Krebs cycle. Krebs cycle produce two FeTH2 molecules. So all FeTH2 molecules enter complex 2, second complex. At the second complex, FeTH2 oxidize to FeD+. Clear? Release both electrons and protons into complex 2. Hence, the first electron acceptor is FeD. FeD in second complex. FeD stands for FeD. Stands for flavin adenine dinucleotide. Flavin adenine dinucleotide. Clear? FAD stands for flavin adenine dinucleotide. Okay. FAD to iron sulfur protein. FES. FES to ubiquinone. Ubiquinone to ubiquinol. Ubiquinol. Ubiquinol to cytochrome B. Cytochrome B to iron sulfur. Iron sulfur to cytochrome C1. Clear? So cytochrome C1 to cytochrome C. Okay, that means what? Complex 3 pick up electrons from complex 1 and from complex 2. Clear? Okay. Then cytochrome C is a type of mobile electron carrier which transfer electrons from complex 3 to complex 4. In complex 4, there are 4 electron carriers. Copper A, cytochrome A, cytochrome A3, copper B, etc. There are 2 copper centers. There are 2 copper centers, copper A and copper B. And there are 2 cytochrome carriers, namely cytochrome A and cytochrome A3. Their sequence is very important, you don't confuse. You must by heart it. You must practice it on paper once or twice. So follow sequence. Cytochrome C donate the electrons into copper A, copper A to cytochrome A, cytochrome A to cytochrome A3, then cytochrome B, sorry, copper B, copper B to oxygen. Here one important point, which is the final electron acceptor, means oxygen. I'm showing here. So this oxygen pick up electrons. Already protons are there in matrix of mitochondria. In matrix of mitochondria, already protons are there. So by taking protons and electrons, oxygen produce water. That is called respiratory water. It is known as respiratory water. Clear? Because oxygen is the final ultimate electron acceptor. Even proton acceptor also. Okay. That is about complex 4. So by taking protons from matrix and electrons from complex 4, oxygen produce one water molecule. This is known as respiratory water. Respiratory water directly released into matrix of mitochondria. Clear? Next, go through proton pathway. Proton pathway. Just now I told in the beginning, for each electron, 2 protons translocated from matrix to intermembrane space. Across membrane. Across membrane. Clear? Right. So from complex 1, 4 protons translocated, and from complex 3,